Welcome back. This is Two Plus Politics. The Edo State Governor Godwin Obaseki has formally joined the People's Democratic Party and will now join three other aspirants to vie for the party's governorship ticket for the September 22 election in the state. There are now indications that the People's Democratic Party, who announced a three-day delay in its primary in Edo State, did so to pave the way for the governor Obaseki to pursue his re-election bid on its platform. Joining us to discuss this is Dr. Doyin, former senior special assistant to former President Goodluck Jonathan on public affairs. And good evening, Dr. Okupe.
Hello, good evening.
Yeah, let me start by congratulating you for being a successful survivor. You're not just a survivor, but you are also telling your stories everywhere. May I also use this opportunity to say congratulations to you, and probably you might want to use next 2 minutes to share your lovely experience with us.
Well, thank you very much. I definitely give all the glory to God. It's nothing to do with my whatever that, you know, only attribute to himself. But basically, you know, what I found out since I left the isolation center is embarrassing, is that people are yet to actually come into terms with the reality of the COVID-19 pandemic. It is real, it is true, and the way it is now spreading is because it is now going into the communal stage, is becoming very alarming, and it's because people are not behaving responsibly. The government can only do so much. You know, the major part of this battle now has to be fought by all of us individually, by keeping to the rules and regulations and protocols as enumerated to us by the National Center for Disease Control. I wish that all Nigerians would take this seriously.
Thank you very much. And let's go to the issue of politics. Now, it is now official that Godwin Obaseki is now a member of PDP. How do you feel? Because to a large extent, watching you, let me not preempt your response. How do you feel that Godwin Obaseki is now a member of your party?
Well, I'm not surprised. I mean, if you follow the Nigerian political trajectory in the last 10 years or so, basically, there are no real or true political parties in the country. I'm talking about, a political party really ought to be a party or a group of people who have the same ideas or at least have the same opinion on certain very critical issues in the country and who believe in the same ideology. Obaseki is coming from APC, been in APC for so many years. How he was now break himself in into what PDP believes in, but basically, the problem in Nigeria here is that we use political platforms just to contest elections and to acquire power. So, as far as that is concerned, he has come in, and from my experience and knowledge and information that I have, he's an extremely popular person in Edo. He will definitely write the future and the fortunes of PDP in terms of the aggregate number of governors that we do have.
Okay, Dr. Okupe, for the purpose of the kind of person that you are, your statements are in the public domain, and some of the statements you made in the past, some of us are not surprised, because you seem to be speaking like a statesman now, not a party man. Just for record, are you back in PDP as a member of the party?
I've never left PDP. Since the last presidential election, I was with Bukola Saraki for the primary.
No, I'm referring to pre-2019.
Oh well, I left the party briefly, and I came back. With the Saraki group coming back into PDP, I came in with them, you know, into PDP, and I've been a full-fledged member of PDP since then.
So is that not the kind of conflict that you just alluded to? Do you also believe in the ideology of PDP, or you also see it as a platform?
There was a reason why I left. I left because the leadership of the party, you know, the leadership of the party at that time was becoming extremely very arrogant, remote, and uncontrollable. And it was becoming too difficult for knowledgeable, experienced politicians to even contribute anything whatsoever, okay, you know, to the development of the party. And it appeared, and it was clear to me at that time, that there was no space for any other, you know, for any other opinion or any other matter, you know, that is outside the immediate leadership, you know, as of that time. So, you know, my idea was that maybe if one could move out and get other Nigerians to actually start a real political movement, you know, that would benefit the country, that would be based on ideology, that would be based on opening the space for younger people and all that. That's why I went to Accord Party. Unfortunately, the people in Accord Party did not understand, you know, my thinking, and they were used to not really deepening any democracy. They were just used to being there and, you know, getting whatever they can get at election times and all that. So unfortunately, in something that was regrettable, there was no space also to actually actualize what I had dreamt of. So when the primaries in the PDP came, and my brother and my friend, Dr. Bukola Saraki, the then senior president, approached me and told me he would like to go back to PDP and he was going to contest for the presidency. I believed so much in his candidacy. I believe that he, you know, could usher in a new vista. That's why I went back with them.
Thank you for clearing that. I just need to put the record straight. And back to the issue of PDP in Edo State. Is it fair on those three aspirants who had been in the party that you had to shift the date, wait for someone to come and join the party? Do we need to even have the primaries again? Because all signs, trying to coach you now, is already pointing in one direction. Is that fair from the side of your party now?
I'm going to astonish you. Politics is not about fairness. It's not about fairness. You know, political parties are put together to win elections and to, you know, establish their political ideology. That is in principle. Okay? So when, you know, under the circumstances in which we are in, we really do not have anybody that has the status and the followership of Obaseki in PDP, okay, for now, running for governor. So if we're just looking at how to win the election of the governorship in Edo State, Obaseki is our best bet. It's not fair. I mean, I agree with you 100%, because there are some people who have been mentoring the party from since the last election, and they are really building structures and having hopes and all that. But, you know, when the chiefs are down, okay, we are safer and more likely going to win, you know, this election, especially because we are in opposition. You know, an opposition party, if you must win, you must win overwhelmingly to such an extent that you make it almost impossible for the rigging apparatus of the government and center, you know, to overwhelm you.
That's a very serious statement. And can we look at the prospect? Now, there are a lot of speculations, and I believe that you have a privileged information if you are ready to release it to us. Is Obaseki going to, are you going, is your party going to allow his running mate, if eventually he gets the ticket, to be his running mate, or it would be fair to give one of these aspirants the deputy governorship ticket?
These are issues that are being ironed out. and I do not want to prejudice any movement, I mean any programs of the party. But you know, those issues are being ironed out, and I believe that reason will prevail on all sides at the end of the day. So we'll cross the bridge when we get there.
We'll cross the bridge when we get there. I'm already getting signal that we have to wrap up this segment. Thank you for your time, Dr. Doyin Okupe, former SSA to former president. Good luck, Jonathan. And to also say congratulations for surviving COVID-19. And congratulations to your wife, too, who also survived COVID-19.
Thank you very much. God bless you.
Yes, we will go on a short break, and when we come back, it will be time for you to give you my take on this discussion. Please don't go anywhere. Welcome back. Before I give you my take, this is news just reaching us that the People's Democratic Party has granted Godwin Obaseki's deputy a waiver to contest elective position. This is very, very important. This is just reaching us that the PDP has granted Obaseki's deputy, that's Shaibu, waiver to contest in elective position. And to my take, the voices against defection seem drowning day by day as it has become a norm in our political landscape. The recent defection in Edo State has given credence to the position that we are yet to have political parties. Rather, what we have are political platforms. It has even become a cliche to say there is no ideological difference among these parties. If these sayings are indisputable, what about the electorate who sheepishly follow these political actors across divides? Hence, here is the deal. Can we, as the masses, put on our thinking caps and come to the conclusion that these men are women, are actors, and nothing more? Can we obliterate politics of bitterness and rancor among ourselves? Can we please respect one another's choices without name-calling and political rhetorics? As Edo and Ondo State elections approach, let's make history by having a rancor-free poll. That is my take. I remain yours truly, Kayode Ladeinde, saying bye for now.